Fala pessoal, eu vou pedir licença para vocês hoje para gravar um vídeo em inglês, porque essa mensagem tem que chegar para o mundo inteiro. Vocês já devem estar acompanhando o nosso trabalho internacional de levar as verdades daquilo que acontece no Brasil para o exterior e a comunidade internacional. E esses fatos que estão acontecendo nesse exato momento sobre as mensagens de Alexandre de Moraes vindo à tona merecem essa mesma repercussão mundial. Então, assim sendo, começo agora a falar inglês. E se você conhece algum estrangeiro, por favor, compartilhe esse vídeo com ele. Leve esta mensagem ao maior número de pessoas possível. It's happening now. That's a break news. In Brazil, the WhatsApp messages from Alexandre de Moraes, the Supreme Court Justice in Brazil, that is on the head of all the persecution against the right wing and the conservatives here, is coming up through the hands of the journalist Glenn Greenwald, who is exposing and publishing all of that for the Folha de São Paulo, a far left-wing journal here in Brazil. So you cannot get out the credit from that, saying that the Glenn Greenwald is someone from the far right-wing spectrum of this political movement, or Folha de São Paulo is a right-wing blog, whatever. So starting from that, what is happening now in Brazil? Now we can see through the messages that are coming up how Alexandre de Moraes was doing his persecution against conservatives here in Brazil. So one of the things that we are looking now, reminding that this is only 10%, you have way more things coming up. As Glenn Greenwald said, that is more than 6 gigabytes of files, images, prints, conversations, and all of that, that he's going to publish time after time. Yeah. So what we can see right now is that Alexandre de Moraes, he was used to pick the people who was going to suffer under his investigation. So Alexandre de Moraes, this justice from the Supreme Court, he has a team from the federal police, like a team from the FBI under his control, and they accomplish all of the orders. Doesn't matter if this is legal or illegal, if this is constitutional or inconstitutional. He give the orders and they accomplish with that. This is pretty much bizarre because this system, it does not exist in some of the countries, in the most of the democracies, actually, on the Western Hemisphere. And one of the persons that he chose to start investigation, it was me. And in the orders, he said, doesn't matter what you found something to start investigation against Eduardo Bolsonaro. Because I'm one of the congressmen, reminding that I'm a federal congressman here in Brazil. My father is the former president. I have a brother that is a senator. So it's not only against me, it's against this house that I do represent. So as they did not find nothing about corruption or any other crimes, they tried to drag me to an investigation under Alexandre de Moraes' control, saying that I was connected with an Argentinian guy that was from Argentina, exposing how bizarre was the Brazilian election of 2022. Well, if you cannot criticize electoral process, if you cannot criticize an election, what is the system where you live? Which system is that? It's a dictatorship. Don't you agree with me? More than that, some of the cases when they would like to start an investigation, they create fake emails to email themselves with anonymous denounce to start an investigation. So it's a really dirt system where the judge is not someone far away from the process and the investigation. He is part of that, choosing, selecting who was going to suffer under his investigation. And doesn't matter the arguments, he creates something and start to investigate you. And as in Brazil, we do not have any more someone to stop him, because the Senate should vote the impeachment of this kind of abuse. But the chairman of the Senate never opened the impeachment procedure to start this process against Alexandre de Moraes, for sure, following the due process of law, he was really comfortable to do that. And everything was about the elections and after the election time. So in Brazil, it was less than 2% the difference between Lula da Silva, the pretender, the one who won the 2022 elections, and Jair Bolsonaro. I will let aside and I will not comment about the machines that we use to vote here. Forget about that for a while. Let's talk about the decisions of the electoral court, which had on the chair Alexandre de Moraes. Yes, he's a justice from the Supreme Court, but also on the head, he was the president, the chairman of the electoral court during the Brazilian elections of 2022. The electoral court in Brazil, they judge everything about the elections, they organize and they coordinate the elections in all over the country. I know that this is bizarre too, but in Brazil, it's like that. So what he was using to do is, on the electoral court, you have a central, supposedly, to fight back against misinformation and to preserve the democracy, which I call the Stasi of the Alexandre de Moraes. With this machine on his hand, Alexandre de Moraes was giving order to his employers, including some of the judges that they are Alexandre de Moraes' assistant, to do reports and collect information. And with this report, official reports, they give this to the Supreme Court investigations, as the investigation about the fake news started in 2019. So the fake news investigation is an investigation under the Supreme Court for more than 5 years going on. So he got the report from the electoral court, send this to the Supreme Court, and start to send the orders of prison, freezing banking accounts, seizing passports. And now we can see how it was coming up. He, for example, Alexandre de Moraes and some of his assistants, a judge, his name is André, talking with the head of this information central in the electoral court. They were talking about how to create a report against the journalists Rodrigo Constantino and Paulo Figueiredo, who nowadays are exiled in the United States, to justify the censoring of Alexandre de Moraes to take their passports. Alexandre de Moraes tried to extradite these journalists, Rodrigo Constantino, Paulo Figueiredo, Alan dos Santos, from the United States to Brazil, but the United States refused, they denied this extradition because, in fact, this is not a crime in the United States. When a journalist talks about a government or when they have some sources, this is not a crime in the United States. United States, they do not extradite journalists because of opinion crimes. So as Alexandre de Moraes could not extradite them to Brazil to arrest them, he canceled their passports. So, in fact, they became with no patria. They became people without passports that they cannot leave the United States using the Brazilian passport. So this is the kind of people that we are talking. And in Brazil, the elections of 2022, it was decided for a margin of less 2% of the votes. So forget again about the machines. Can we imagine that the elections was decided by a judge that, for example, did not let Jair Bolsonaro using during his campaign in television images of Maduro together with Lula? I had to delete some posts from social media relating Lula da Silva with Daniel Ortega, which is the dictator of Nicaragua. You could not talk about the involvement of the Labor Party of Lula da Silva and the organized crime in Brazil with the drug dealers of the PCC, which in Brazil means Primeiro Comando da Capital, the largest organized crime in Brazil. Doesn't matter if the facts appoint
for this kind of relationship between the Labour Party and the PCC. You could not say that Lula da Silva was in favor of abortion. Nowadays, the ministers of Lula talk about legal abortion. They want to flexibilize the access of drugs, bring some privilege for the drug dealers. Some of them, if they can approve this kind of bill, some of the drug dealers, they will be released from jail. So in fact, the 2022 elections, it was forbidden to us to do opposition against Lula da Silva, because Alexandre de Moraes was in the mission to kill this spontaneous and voluntary movement started and led by Jair Bolsonaro. Less than 2%. Is that in your country legal for a judge do investigation only against right-wing people? Can we call that as a democracy? Or does it look like a dictatorship? So this is what is going on now in Brazil, and this is just the beginning. It's just the top of the iceberg. Way more things are coming up. Glenn Greenwald already said that. We didn't see nothing until now, but we already saw enough to start an impeachment procedure. This is now what we are working here in the Congress with the senators to start a movement to impeach Alexandre de Moraes. Some people are starting in the conversations to organize street protests peacefully, as always we did. So paying attention to what is going on in Brazil. This virus tomorrow can be in your home, in your country, in your homeland. So that's what I would like to talk to you. And once again, paying attention. Follow everything that is going on. Journalist Glenn Greenwald, he's not a Brazilian, he's American. For sure he's going to do a bunch of interviews explaining more and more about that. Because if this free speech get killed, there is no democracy anymore. And this is the stage that where we are nowadays. So God bless Brazil. And we hope that things can be changed here. Thank you.